Hello, and welcome to today's program. That's a very diverse welcome sign. You're now what? Well, you're not watching Dallas.
What's happening, everyone? It's DJ Angelo, and as you can see, I'm back in my hat, which can only mean one thing. That's right, I've got a brand new turntable tutorial for you.
From government to resident, Reptilian awareness for the uninitiated, narrated by... Yours truly, Professor Reginald Oaks, no relation to the Pokemon Master.
I could even play record 2 just half a beat behind record 1, or even a quarter beat behind record 1.
Let's start with the basics. What is a reptilian, you may ask? It is not this furry creature, I assure you. Ah, yes, that's more like it.
I was right in the middle of a fucking reptile zoo. And somebody was giving booze to these goddamn things. It won't be long now before they tear us to shreds.
The reptilians, or the draconians, have lived amongst mankind for eons and forever ago. Originating from the Alpha Draconis star system, these reptilian-human hybrids will stop at nothing to control our brains and our government. Much speculation has arose as to where they come from, what they're doing here, or if they exist. But as a tenured professor of ufology, herpetology, and alien biology, I can 100% guarantee all of you that the reptilians are... They are... And they already... Research begins with one man named Mr. David Icke. This guy right here. What a handsome man, no, I digress.
In 1990, Mr. David Icke met a psychic in the woods. The psychic told Mr. Icke that he was put on Earth to be a healer to all, and he would receive multiple messages from the spirit world.
Welcome to our graveyard.
I wanna fuck tonight. In 1991, Mr. David Icke, the prodigal son, returned to hold a press conference, and he revealed that all along he was indeed the son of the Godhead. Stemming from a career in pro football, sports presenting and announcing, and being a spokesperson for the Green Party, there is no individual more qualified to speak about intergalactic alien control of governments than Mr. David Icke. Notice on the frame, notice how I squat in the rain. Okay, pain, it's temporary, rare. I'm about to mile way back in February.
As we see the buckets, now there's a third bucket this week. I think what happened, there's always been like a mother and father. Like this is a father bucket, this is a mother bucket, and since the last game, they had a baby bucket.
Reptilians are Hillary Clinton, Macaulay Carton, Jonathan Depp, Rick Gervais, Brangelina, Keith Sutherland, David Icke, Michelle Obama, this guy, that guy, her, and yes, even him. And did you know that if you rearrange the letters in the word him, you spell Barack Hussein Obama? Recent footage has showed us a shocking new and true side to our black president.
He calls himself one of the lucky seven.
Reptile.
And he'll tell you he was shot four times on that day, and he has three bullets that are still inside him. And when I asked him about what he thought we should be doing, he said, I'm not here because of what happened to me. I'm here because of what happened to me keeps happening to other
people. Reptile.
Do something about it.
Reptile.
We will.
Reptile.
I promise you, we will. This is our intention. We must do what we can now. And there's no person who is more committed to acting on this moral obligation we have than the President of the United States of America. Ladies and gentlemen.
Reptile.
Thank you. Thank you so much. Thank you, everybody. Please have a seat. Good afternoon, everybody. Let me begin by thanking for your dedication
to
this issue, for bringing so many different voices to the table, because while reducing gun violence is a complicated challenge, protecting from harm shouldn't be a divisive one.
That was a clip from National Geographic's Living with the Big Cats. Shocking, I know. It is all right if you wish to join group therapy. I won't judge you. I know what you are thinking to yourself now. Anyone I know can be a reptile. So the question is, what do I do next?
One thing I do know, don't you get bit. Bites kill you. The fever burns you out. But then after a while...
Hey, you alive in there?
Come back.
Who the hell are you, man?
Officer Flynn.
You're a cop.
All I am anymore is a man looking for his wife and son. Anybody gets in the way of that's gonna lose.
Estreia em simultâneo em todos os canais Fox.
It's been my personal pleasure to spend this evening of stimulating education with all of your young, feeble minds. The lesson of today's program is don't trust gypsies and kill all the reptilians before they kill us. I've been your narrator, Reginald Oaks, the professor. Make sure to tune in October 13th on National Geographic for their special Living with the Big Cat special. As always, this documentary was
recorded in front of a live studio audience in Nickelodeon Studios at Universal Studios, Florida.